How can I face life? Bricks. When you're all I'm living for.
What's good? What's good? This is the assembly line. This is your host, Jay Wiz, my co-host.
It's your man, Brixton Bang, your baby mother's second cousin, twice removed, favorite producer on the microphone.
Talk that shit.
Yes, sir.
And we got a super producer in the building today, my man, Raw Traxx.
Raw.
Yo, yo, yo. I'm here.
Welcome to the assembly line, brother. This is the show where we cook up on the spot. You know what I mean? Like,
oh, man.
We basically collab, you know what I mean, with every producer that came in here and made, like, some crazy shit. So I know we about to make some legendary shit today.
Oh, man.
So before we get into the blueprints.
Oh, yeah. Let me load that up.
We like to just try to just, you know, do a wrap up, a catch up of the events that has come across, you know, since the last show. You know, you got the, you know, the Jada thing and the Tory thing and the Nick thing. So, you know, yeah, we got a few topics that we can go off of real quick before we start anything.
You
try to get everybody's opinion on a few items and stuff. So,
you know, it's I feel like in a sense, where you want to start? I want to start with Nick Cannon.
Talk about Nick.
Let's talk about Nick.
Nicky.
Like, I feel like he spoke truthfully. You feel me? But at the same time, like my man Brick say, don't bite the motherfucking hand that feeds you. You know what I'm saying? But now he lost the show, and you know, most of them people are gonna ride for him. You know what I mean? Or do you think they gonna go that same route? And like, hey, they ain't none of my business. I'm still trying to work. I'm still trying to get this money.
The reality of it is they keep feeding Nick's ego. And Nick Cannon think he boss. Because he got his own company and he's done these big shows. I get it.
He got that money now.
You got that money. But at the same time, it's like going into work and be like, you know, go tell your boss he ain't shit. But it's like, well, I'm not going to keep you on if you think if I ain't shit. I'm like, the people you talk about, Nick, is the people that literally kind of own your shows.
I mean,
it's not like what you're saying is probably not true. It's just, you know, certain shit.
So he wasn't talking about his boss. He was talking about others.
Yeah, people in general.
Yeah, them same motherfuckers probably own your bosses. So. So
I'm just saying. I hear when Oprah just.
Yeah, I saw the $10 million.
$10 million want to bring him on the show, so he gonna have some opportunities. He gonna have
and Puff and Diddy said, "Yo, you got a home at Revolt."
Two things: number one, ain't nobody trying to watch Revolt. Okay, wait. The Drink Champs is the only show I watch.
Wow,
and maybe Breakfast Club. There's nothing else is worth watching.
They got the stars somewhere.
They gotta be like clicking channels. Like, oh shit, that's Revolt. Anything else? Nope. Okay, keep going.
I'm dead.
Revolt had nothing on. And then Oprah, what, you got to get like 5 Tyler Perry shows, then Wildin' Out, then more Tyler Perry shows?
Yeah. And then you get Wildin' Out.
Exactly.
Again.
You got 3 shows about God and peace, and you got...
He got to change the name. They own that, bro.
Wildin' Out, too. That's their show. Like somebody said, still Wildin' Out.
No.
You got Sold Out.
Still Wildin' Out.
Still Wildin' Out, yeah. Hey.
And plus the $10 million, that always speaks for itself.
Big facts.
Or even just Still Wildin'.
Still Wildin'.
That's what I would have did.
I would just call it, I guess we doing this now.
My new show.
Hey,
you know what I'm saying?
I saw the post. It was like, hey man, we need to support Nick, you know what I'm saying? Because he been looking out for us. Let's play his music all day.
I just love the music.
Don't do that. You don't got to do that.
I just love the music where they got like Ryan Seacrest or Gary Owens.
Just watch reruns.
As his replacements. That's just funny as hell. Yeah. Can you imagine Ryan Seacrest as the host of Wildin' Out?
That's crazy.
Dude.
But yeah, man, that's it's music industry stuff that's going on, man. That's one of the things that's happening, and it's pretty fucking crazy. Like, it was an insane event, like, to see that happen to, like, somebody just was, you know, freedom of speech.
You saw how quick it was, too, right?
Yeah.
Everybody else.
Oh, you said what? Yeah. Boop. Bob,
apologize that you're losing Fox, too.
Yeah.
Fuck that.
That's all that's happened there.
You have to. It's like, you can't really speak your mind anymore.
Nah.
No matter how much
unless you're the president.
Tell kids that, the reality of it is that you can't, because you're always going to hurt somebody's feelings.
Fuck the feelings.
You just will.
For real.
Everybody is sensitive. It's like, even like people are talking about old boy's girlfriend, because she posted a like Instagram photo of Asian night, and she was dressed up like Asian style. So it's like, in reality, it's like, if you're a white person, there's nothing you can do anymore for the culture. You fucked. If you go to anything casino night, and you go to casino night, post that shit up, now maybe you're offending Italians. Who knows? You know what I'm saying? Who you offending now? You can't do shit if you white no more. Luckily, I'm black, so I don't worry about that shit. But I'm just saying, if you white, you need to make sure that you check your shit before you take a photo.
And fuck that.
So, real talk.
Yeah, man, that's crazy. But on the other side, let's talk about these beats.
Hey, I just want to say one thing, man.
Go ahead.
I appreciate y'all having me here, man, to hang out with y'all.
Oh, yeah, man. Most definitely.
For real. I really appreciate that.
He's definitely on the list of people I want to have on here. I still got to get through more because I want Crazy on here, too. Mm-hmm. So I'm just trying to.
He'll be dope.
Yeah, we got a lot of.
Crazy going to bring presents and stuff. He going to bring you some drum kits and VSTs and.
Yeah, y'all bring it crazy. Crazy going to bring this equipment. I'm like. I'm about to find a way.
He gonna give you something. He gonna give you some.
Every damn doll. So I'm like, damn,
Super producer. Super producer.
Yeah, I'm about to set up Crazy in the hallway because he gonna have all the equipment and shit.
You gotta set him up on a green screen,
right? Because he gonna have that heat.
But let me ask you some tracks. So when you started producing, who was the five producers that inspired you, like, that wanted to become a producer? Like, your top five, Mount Rushmore, though.
Okay. It's crazy, but I got to put on, I got to say, it's going to be crazy, but Jermaine Dupri, one of them.
He definitely deserved that respect.
And Babyface is another.
Yeah, Babyface.
I mean, he's dope. All the right. If you talk about super producer, that's one of them.
Facts.
I like Dr. Dre. Can't forget about Dr. Dre.
Most definitely.
I mean, we might actually get a fucking new album and shit because I gave his wife half the money.
Oh, yeah, pretty much. Man.
I mean, real talk.
Got bills to pay.
He got bills now, so we actually might get another fucking album out of Dre.
Yeah.
Who else? So that's three?
That's three. I got to say, one of my partners, man, that really showed me how to produce and how to make beats, that goddamn Black Boy.
Black Boy is a motherfucking
goddamn
weird. Shout out to Black Boy.
What up, boy?
Yeah, Black
Boy. He was actually on here, man. Yeah, he
was the first one to sit me down.
Hey, though, he got it, though. And he can sing and rap, bro. Make beats, record, super producer.
Like, when he started singing and stuff, I was like, oh, shit, y'all, it's Tyrese in the building.
Yo. Tyrese, oh, yeah. He get that all the time.
Yeah, man, he's fire. He's fucking fire.
And number five now, probably. I'm on number five. Man.
Number five for your fifth one, a new producer, the new age producers.
If I say new age, it's not too many. I'm glad if I say new, and he's not new, but he's new.
Yeah,
Zay Tobin.
Okay,
you know I really appreciate I like his work. so I was all around the board with those five people. So
okay,
that's where I get it. Those
so you let's say like your sound is them like in one basically.
I can say that, yeah. Okay. I can say that, yeah. Okay. But that's really that hits it right there. God damn. When nice. My sound from the R&B stuff that I like to do, from the making songs for kids, Jermaine Dupri, from playing the piano, Zaytoven, and yeah, that's it.
That's a lot of
sampling and having heavy beats, stacking drums, Dr. Dre.
Dre.
Yeah, so yeah, that's it right there. Yeah.
I like that. So you work with kids. Like produce for kids and make songs for kids?
I ain't gonna say I work with kids. I got one I'm about to work with, 9-year-old from Orlando.
Okay.
About to do what I'm trying to figure out what we're gonna do with him. But yeah, that's, you know, try something different, you know.
Trying
to be a producer.
Thank you.
Try something different, man.
It's a difference between, like, we had the discussion yesterday, you know, I posted it on Facebook, you know what I mean? Like, it's a difference between producers and beat makers. Now, there's nothing wrong with beat makers.
No.
But the producers change the game. Like, those are the ones that paved the way, man.
Yeah, change the sound and make, yeah, those ones that makes a new sound, kind of, exactly. You know?
Exactly.
Yeah.
I like that. So, last show. Serge, he gives us like a sample to flip. Like, so, and me and Brixton flip the sample. So each week, well, each show, we flip a different sample. And this week was the Fox intro.
Yeah, 20th Century Fox.
20th Century Fox intro. We had the sample.
Yeah, everybody knows it. Dan, 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 dan,
dan, dan. You go first, Brix.
Is that how we do here? Is that how we do here? You just tell me to go first? That's not how we do here. Come on, man. It's been a minute.
Oh, I'm sorry. So, then each round, we rock, paper, scissors. So whoever wins controls the round.
The rounds are what?
Like each time we make a beat.
So if he wins, he could pick, oh, I want to do 85 BPM. Or I want to do the kicks. Or I want to do the melody.
Okay.
So, that's how we go. All right, so we ain't do this in a while.
It's been a minute, yeah. It's outside
for you. You know what I'm saying? I'm about to be...
Get the rust off. Let's go.
No, she ain't got no nipples! All right, you ready, Bean?
Yeah, I'm ready, son.
Boom, 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 boom.
Damn, motherfucker!
Thought you been one. Thought I seen a
nah, it's
two out of three.
Best out of three.
Best out of three.
Yeah, yeah, he got
you.
Me.
Go first.
See what happens when you put the boobs down on the USB thing.
Shit. So this is my
my bad
Fox joint.
The titties are fucked shit up, y'all.
It's working. It's working. It's working. Don't touch it. Ah, you touched it. You made it worse. Why did you do that?
It's all good.
It's coming back. It'll come back.
So this is my Fox joint. I flip.
Let's go.
Can I get some sound money?
Ready? Boom. There you go.
What's the original sample?
Oh, you got the original? Hold on. Let's see if I can probably get it. That's the original. We'll be right back.
Fox Flip.
Okay, okay. I'm fucking with that. I would get that song probably with the next time.
Yeah. You ready for the search?
Let's go.
Like, usually when I, like, I don't know, my chopping style come from A-Rap. So, like, I want it to sound distinctive, but I don't want you to know where I got the sample from.
Yeah.
You feel me? I'm a little, you know what I mean? People who got good ears, they, oh, I know where that's from.
See, you know what I'm saying? I was like the Jess Blaze train situation.
Yeah.
I watched all his stuff and try exactly. to do chops like the stabs. Stats.
Yeah, I like Just Blaze too.
Yeah, Just Blaze is stupid.
Mm-hmm. His manager had to get him to quit.
What?
Work. He's like, man, you already making a bunch of money.
Yeah.
Man, why you sitting here for? And he thought about it like, yeah, you're right. He quit.
Hey.
That's hilarious.
You can do it.
Like, yeah. Bro, why are you here right now?
Yeah, you
not my boss.
Money.
He was probably like, yo, can I get off early tonight? I gotta be at this Dr. Dre show. They want me on stage. Like, why are you even working here? Bro, this is Staples.
That's what he says.
Let's get one good single. We already out the door. Like, bye, y'all.
Hey. I'm out here.
Hey, fuck the job.
Can I cut out early? That's a good one. I like that guy.
He making a lot of money, and he was still going to work.
Yeah.
That's good, though.
Yeah. Not me.
It's that routine, probably. It's probably the routine.
Yeah. Nigga, first single, didn't even get the check yet from BMI. I'm already out. Bye. I already see the potential. Bye, y'all. It played on the radio station twice already. I'll see you later.
So, where we going, Bricks?
You know, I'm going to have Ross start us off, man. He got the piano out, so I'm going to see what he's going to groove with.
I don't know, man.
What we're all going to do?
Oh, man.
Just pick the BPM. And then
go from there.
Do me a solid and take out the power.
Take it out?
Yeah. You got enough juice to make it?
Okay. Nah.
Okay, we'll keep it. We'll just
have
it.
What?
Because listen. You hear it now? Now plug it in.
Calling. What BPM? Just pick the BPM and you can go.
Wait, but once the music gets going, we won't hear it. So
it's about 85.
85?
Yeah,
let me just mute it till then.
I'm at 120.
Huh?
I'm at 120.
You want 120? Okay.
Ooh. Hello. My bad.
All together.
Oh, man.
Put 120. Pieces.
I always thought
can throw something and then we can go or whatever. How y'all want me to do?
Yeah,
I have some new shit that can, I got, got some stuff from Splice the other day that came through.
Oh,
my partner, he used that a lot.
Yeah, I just got on that too, like that Splice.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's what one of my partners.
You got
used.
My. I don't hear nothing. I don't even hear the click. My tempo on.
Turn me up, sorry.
Mark Anthony coming on.
Back to you.
Yo, where the big ass at?
I feel like I'm in a fight stage in Street Fighter. Get yourself a bag of salsita. Spicy salsa flavored tortilla. The dip is in the tea. Salsita salsa chips. Our authentic gourmet tortilla flavored mighty spicy salsa seasoning. Salsitas are cooking to a light crunchy texture. Delicate seasoning with a tasty blend of tomato, onion, garlic.
I don't know what he got going on.
I'm making a commercial. Let me make a commercial. I'm trying to get a sponsorship.
Like that you've worked with so far was like, man, like this this dude is talented, or this person is talented, should I say? Like, what artist stuck out
here,
to you
in the city?
Yeah,
there's a lot of good talent in the city. Just to be frank, to be real, but who I worked with that was dope is that goddamn Money Lonnie.
Money who?
Money Lonnie.
Money Lonnie.
Yeah.
Okay. I gotta look him up. I'm gonna be honest. I haven't.
Oh, he's dope.
Yeah.
I think he's the next one to get signed from
time. Nice. Nice. So,
and give out to the shout out to all the artists who has just got deals.
Mm-hmm. Big fact.
That's dope. So they let you know that they are watching Tampa right now.
Oh yeah.
What's you know, and shout out to LA the GOAT with Jermaine Dupri.
Mm-hmm.
And Roboy with Gucci.
Yeah. Roboy got some.
Shout out to Roboy too on his recently acquisition of that to Switch.
Facts, because he's talented. That young man is talented.
It's a lot of them here. There's a lot of them in town, but just they just need that chance, just need a voice.
Yeah.
We just need like a quality control type label. That just
facts.
You ain't gonna find
I think
that
we found like a label that like that's pretty much how it happens now is that a label sets up in the city, got backers and knows what they're doing, and then it just
Yeah.
You know?
And just go from there.
Yeah, it's just like with Def Jam in New York, it's like, it just... It
again, this is Tampa, Florida.
Yeah, I know.
It ain't going to happen.
We just need a label that just can do it.
Now, so, like by you saying that, like, it ain't going to happen, right? So, it's a lot of people that don't like helping each other. Or they'll say, hey, I don't know this person. Even though he's dope, I'm not going to even give him a look because I don't. He's not in my inner circle. It's a lot of, like, clicked up people in every city, though. You know what I'm saying? But, like, how do you feel? Like, you feel like, if this person has talent, like, they should be heard. Or at least help them to get to be heard.
There's only so much help you can do, you know. Well, a lot of when the rapper, especially the young rapper, don't see that vision, can't see it, how you see it. So it's tough. When
I mean, producers too, though. It's a lot of fire producers in the city.
Oh,
it's
a lot of fire. Man, Tampa is talented with a lot of fire people. You know what I'm saying? And we just like Atlanta. I tell my homeboy, he's from Cali.
Mm-hmm.
I tell him all the time, man, Tampa's just like Cali, man. We got the same weed y'all got. We can't give it out. Smoke it like y'all can, but all that shit.
We like to think we can. But the police let us know that no, we can't.
But you know, then again, like I said, they're very, it's like you said.
But we're just like a little California, just like Atlanta. We just ain't got the resources here. We ain't got the people with the money here, the big people with the money.
I wouldn't even say it's a resource. I just say there's support.
We don't have the resources. I mean,
we just need, like I said, one label that's willing.
That's the resource.
Yeah.
That's to the everywhere resource. We talking about. Atlanta got that resource. California got that resource.
I don't get me wrong. Atlanta got a shitload of labels.
Yeah,
but that, I keep saying QC because
big facts.
They stand out, and
they came from the bottom, and yeah. You know they. Dudes that's street dudes that got a label and made something happen. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Facts.
It's just like with No Limit. It's like at the time when it was at, there was not a lot of people that was doing that kind of music or had a kind of label system. But then Mass Speed got money and then was able to help bring up people and artists in that particular area.
But he had that vision. He can see it. Mm-hmm. Well, a lot of other people, I'm pretty sure they didn't see it. But he saw it and he made it happen. And you know, I kind of believe that I'm that type of person that can make things happen for people, but it's hard for me. I mean, it's hard. I ain't got that type of money to make things happen. But, you know,
you always don't need money. You could just put that person in the position, and if they don't capitalize off of it, that's on them.
It takes money to put them in that position. It takes money. It takes knowing. If you don't have the money, mm-hmm. you got to at least be in the right building.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Be around the right people. You don't got to have money to be around the right people. Yeah, but you got to know somebody to be around the right people to rub shoulders. And it's not here. So that's why, you know, you have to go to Atlanta. You have to travel. Not just Atlanta. Yeah. You got to travel. Small town, trust Florida. Me, you got to move around.
Trust me. I'll be on that.
A lot of people and a lot of artists, they mind stuck in one spot. And it's hard for them to move mm-hmm. around, you know, when they don't see it. The vision. Yeah. So it's hard, you know. Yeah. It's real
you
hard.
You gotta put in a lot of time, man. And sometimes even you put in all that time, sometimes that's not even enough.
It's not. And I put a lot of time, man. I'm old. I'm 40 years old now. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? I've been doing it for a long time. I done had chances. I done work with Gucci. I done work with Rocco. You know, and by me doing that was me being with a label that crumbled through federal stuff. It crumbled, but I didn't have any money, but I was around the people that had the money.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? That was able to put me in that position, put me around these people. They paid for these people to come to the studio and work, and I was the broke dude producer that was there. Mm-hmm. And it happens like that a lot. You know what I'm saying? Who you with? You know, your resources. Do your resources, you might not have the money, but do your resources have the money to put you in those positions?
Yeah.
You just got to be there. So
true.
And it happened like that's majority. That's how it happened a lot like that.
See me, I'm be that producer in the room where everybody got money, and I know that I ain't gonna get that money because producers don't never get no check. I'm gonna just
but if
like,
you be around the real resource people,
yeah,
they gonna put that money in your hand. Yeah. They gonna look out for you if you're around the right people. They gonna look out for you. You know, and
it's like always like producers are always fighting to get that check.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? It's like
that's why
because they're not doing it by the books. Like, if you hit them with split sheets off a rip, Most of the time, if they ain't about that business, they're going to walk
and
away.
That's the thing. It'd be about the split sheets, and it'd be about the business part, you know, of the game where a lot of people are not going to make money. Producers not going to make money. And you just got to keep working, man. I mean, the money is there. You got to put yourself around the right people. You know what I'm saying? You gonna get shitted on. That's just part of the game. Everybody got shitted on, man.
Facts. That's what he was telling me. That's what he was like, hey, man, you know,
it's how you learn.
That's how you learn.
Over, boy, you stick and move.
Oh, they screwed me. Go on to the next one.
Keep it moving. Okay.
It's a tough business, man, and we just, you know, good people got to look out for each other, man. That's what it is, man.
That's a fact. That's
gotta look out for each other.
So, like, ever since, like, I actually, like, got back on the scene after I got out of the military. So, like, my goal was to, like, try to help everybody. You know what I'm saying? Like, if, like, I know you're a dope producer, you feel me? I'm going to let people know. You understand? Like, it's like my boy Wild Child. Crazy. Crazy stupid talent. You feel me? And then other boy Dilapo. They have the sound. You feel me? They just, like...
It's a lot of people like
that.
You
know what I mean? But
it's
And then I tell, hey, look, I know somebody who can make that for you. Boom. I plug them in, link them in. You know what I mean? It's not too many people that do that. You feel me? And I'm trying to, like, build
And that's the part of building
exactly
this brand here in Tampa, you know, spreading the word. Because, you know, you've been a producer and you say, oh, he's dope. Go check him out. You're telling your homeboy who's a rapper to go check them out, get some beats from them.
Yeah.
And they might make the hit.
Yeah, exactly.
But now you on that same album. So now you know, you got to have people that look out like that. And that's how it's going to work here in Tampa, man. You got to open your arms and you can't be a crab. You got to happy till you see somebody that's a good producer.
I think just the people
producer.
That know they are not that are not the crabs just all need to move together. That's what it needs to happen.
Yeah, but it's not hard for, you know, if you're a producer that's already doing stuff and you see this, you know, and you see
this up and comer or whatever.
Yeah,
you
don't have to. You don't have to look out. You don't have to. You know what I'm saying? But that's how this city going to come up because when you look at Atlanta, I'm reading Gucci Man book. And Gucci Man, oh, man, his book is dope how he helped people and how people helped him. You know what I'm saying? How he just spread his love out to everybody.
That's all
you
got to do.
You know what I'm saying? And that's how, and not just
that's
him
the
did
way,
that.
Man.
T.I., other artists did that in the city. Other producers did that. You know, rappers, like Lil Baby, he wouldn't even think about being a rapper. Yeah. But somebody else, man, come in this booth, man. Yeah. Come to
when
the booth.
Do that,
and you know what I'm saying?
It be like that, though. It really do.
And he ain't the only one. Pee Wee Longway, I mean, a lot of rappers, they weren't even rappers. They were just trappers and hanging with the rappers.
Yeah.
That's how Easy started.
Easy
wasn't a rapper?
They was really like, hey, you need this? I see you got talent. I'm going to push for you. Boom.
Yeah,
and then one day he in the
like
studio
this.
And.
Yeah.
Drop that verse and goddamn, that shit go.
So next time I'm in the studio, y'all, if y'all want me to go in that booth,
holla at your boy.
Let me know.
Got some bars for you.
Let me know.
Get him.
Okay, I may not be able to do shit, but hey.
Get him.
We don't know. We don't know.
What's going on, cuz?
Get him.
So now this show, you can play, you know, you can promote a song that you would like to promote or a beat, you know what I mean, that you want to promote. Whatever you've been working on, man, you just let the people know.
A couple tracks, new tracks I've been working on. I can play something for Money Lonnie. I can play.
Yeah, I want to hit him. Let me hit him.
He got a mixtape he just dropped. I played something old that we was, you know, we was on the radio heavy with this song that I did. And the thing about this, another thing about being a producer, this beat I made for him, he did not like it. He had everything written and he didn't like it. Man, drop the goddamn song, man.
Right.
Drop the song.
He can be that way sometimes.
And it took off for him. He loved it now. He loved it now.
Yeah. Now you like it, huh, motherfucker?
It be like that.
He can get that way sometimes.
Because they don't see it.
They don't see the vision.
Yeah, they don't see the vision. Yeah. And it's understandable. You know, and it happens a lot in the industry.
It
you
does.
Know what I'm saying? And those be the songs that take off.
Mm-hmm.
So you gotta nudge him a little bit. Like, come on. It's okay.
He did not like this song. But, I'm like, man, I done made this beat.
Like, you gonna use
this
beat.
You gonna jump this beat, man.
Big facts. Big facts, yo. It's all about the vibes, man. You gotta create a vibe. You know what I'm saying? If you establish that vibe with somebody and y'all work cohesively. You know what I'm saying? Work well together. Y'all can do something. You know what I'm saying?
And like, then we were talking about, too, about a lot of beats that we hear on the radio, I hear on a mixtape, on an album, they don't really be nothing. The artist, sometimes the artist makes that beat better than what it was.
Yeah.
I hear that a lot. You know, it'd be a simple beat, but, and the producer, like, damn, how? Because he know the right people. He in the building with the people who can, hey, go jump on this song. Go find something. The A&R, go find something he got.
No, he right.
You know what I'm saying? I've done that, like, yo, I'll be like, yo, how? And like, it's literally like four sounds, bruh. Four sounds in that bit. It's like
808s.
Exactly. That's
but sometimes the rapper, what he says on it, how good his vocals are on the beat, cut through the beat, makes the beat. As long as you got a boom and a clap.
Facts.
You know, and this I hear.
Like, people get mad at some things I do because they're like, you had this one dude who put all this orchestration in his song. And it's damn nice.
Yeah.
But then I'll go against them, and my shit only got like five sounds. Everybody like, oh, that's hot.
It be like that. It really be like that.
Yeah, it took him like forever because he got to put all these different patterns and shit together. I was like, my shit is like done in 5 minutes. But people just won't, sometimes just bangers. They don't want to think. They just won't dance.
They want that.
They just want that hate.
Let me see if I can find this. There's a dope stuff out there for him. We got more stuff. But hey, we still working. A couple of new artists I'm working with in the city too.
That's good.
I like. I got an artist named Liachi the Great. Mm-hmm. Oh, he's a dope artist too. Very dope. Oh, he on in the booth. Easy for him.
So the artist is finding you, or you find the artists?
Now you have to find them. I mean, it's both ways. But if you want, if you hear a dope artist, and you know they'll sound dope on your beat, whatever you make, you know, because like these artists, these two artists who I named. I can give them any type of beat because a lot of artists you can give them beat and they don't want that.
Yeah,
we were just we
literally just had that conversation.
We were just talking about that,
and it's understand. I understand it's like that. But you got some artists
that no, who,
kill
want,
that bitch.
I want. And those I want the this
that's
sound.
How you make that sound.
Yeah, like to me, it's like we was, me and him was trying to hiccup. We was like, I don't understand some artists where it's like it's five different producers, but the sound is the same throughout the entire album. And I was like, you know, like my sound was like, but you want me to make this type of sound? But I'm like, I don't do that.
Yeah.
Come to me because I make this sound.
This beat, yeah.
Why do you want me to make what everybody else on your album is already making?
Yeah.
Like, I don't understand that. Like,
and it's just like I seen from one producer, I learned from one producer, I just read something. Somebody sent me something. Some type of producer, something, podcast or something. And one producer say, man, you got to control the room when you playing your beats.
Control the vibes.
Yeah, you got to control that when you play your beats.
You do.
You know, so you can't make them tell you, no, this is what I do. This is what is going on.
Yeah.
Give them ideas or so they can understand, so they can see the vision.
Yeah.
Exactly. A lot of time they ain't.
That's a producer.
Yeah.
Yeah, they ain't going to see the vision.
Like, I got a singer I'm working with, Michael Jomay. When I tell you this, man, it's like a human jukebox. Like, whatever you put on, I got it. And here you go.
And like, he's a good one to have.
He's
so creative.
Exactly. His range is crazy.
Like, he's the kind of person you want in the room when you're writing.
Yeah.
Right, yeah.
Dope writer, too.
Dope writer. I'm wrestling with an R&B, one of Craigslist artists named Joe. He's another one. I can play
anything. Young Joe.
Yeah, he's three. You can play anything for him.
Fire.
And that was about. It's about having been a writer, not just a singer. If you're a singer and a writer who can write to anything, that's how you make hits, though.
Yeah,
exactly.
You can write to anything. Everybody can't do that. You know
what I'm saying? Like, a lot of artists where it's like, well, I only want the Florida sound. I was like, yeah, but that means you're only going to be stuck in Florida.
Yeah.
I was like, you want...
A universe
range. Like, why would you only want this particular sound? Like, you already have that here. Now find a New York sound or find something that you want to compliment everything across the board, just not one place.
Exactly.
And that's what I was telling Money Lion the other day. I sent him a bunch of beats and I sent him some reggaeton beats. he didn't say no. He said, I got to listen to him a couple more times to get that vibe. And I told him, like, man, me as a producer and somebody he listened to, I'm like, you can do this. It's easy for you to do because you already can. You already got. You can do that accent. You know, you're not, reggaeton. I know that's not you.
You got to catch them pockets.
You can do this, though. Yeah. He can do it. He can because he got that.
he got that. He can do that. His vibe. He can rap any way you want him to rap. He can rap like he from Atlanta. Mm-hmm. He can sing rap. So he got so many different tools he can use.
Yeah. My thing is like, what if you get on with an artist who wants you on one of his songs? Well, you can't be like, I don't know how to do it.
Yeah, he can.
Like
do
if there's
it,
a check
it.
And it's like, exactly. What are you gonna do? If you spend all your time doing one particular sound across the way, can you do anything else?
You're gonna be stuck.
Like my thing is like for example, like Rod Wave makes. The Rod Wave type, you know, Shaq said a lot of people pretty much do
Roddy
now.
Rich, all that, yeah.
So my thing is, if you take Rod Wave and let's say Busta Rhymes, like, I want you on the track, can you really see Rod Wave, can he really adapt to that? Like, is he an artist that can adapt?
He go, his management gonna make him, hey, it's a check, bro.
Hey, you better.
I'm pretty sure he gonna change, yeah, I'm pretty sure he will.
It's like, as an artist, you should know how to adapt.
Let me hear this song, brother.
It's an old song.
But,
shit you do, and I'm just kinda hoping we can see this issue through. I feel alone on top of that shit, I miss you too. Yeah. You always got your pride in the way. Told you too many times, I ain't lying to you, babe. Ain't no use to talking, you gon' think I'm lying anyways. So fuck it, I might as well fuck around anyways. Alright. Ain't stressing over nothing, I'ma live my life.
Ooh, I'm gon' live my life.
Married to the money, damn right. I'm single for the night. You ain't gotta fuck with me no more.
You ain't gotta fuck with me no more.
It's time I let you go.
It's time I let you go.
You ain't gotta fuck with me no more.
You ain't gotta fuck with me no more.
Don't be ringing my line. Don't be ringing my line. Ringing my line. Ringing my line. Don't be ringing my line. Ringing my line. Ringing my line.
You ain't gotta fuck with me no more. You ain't gotta fuck with me no more.
Just don't ring my line.
Money Lonnie.
Ringing
my line.
Yeah, I think he one of the next ones that can.
That bit on YouTube deal. Right now. Go check it out.
Yeah,
produced by Raw Traxx. What you got, Bricks?
I got a beat I'm working on.
Beat?
Beats,
okay.
Beats I'm working on. I got other stuff I'm working on, but I can't release it yet.
I feel you.
So, I can only show beat stuff right now.
Yes, yellow wristwatch. Yes, yellow wristwatch. Yes, yellow wristwatch. Yellow wristwatch. Yes, yellow wristwatch. wristwatch. Yep, yellow 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 wristwatch. Gucci flip flops.
Everybody was sampling it back then. Yeah. Shit, Jermaine Dupri did Chris Cross' whole album was sampled.
Yeah, like every song you can think Traxx. Of in back in the day, hip hop was sampled.
Yeah,
but now it's just different because you don't really Atlanta, have to do that as much.
Yeah, Atlanta turned it around.
Yeah,
with the trap stuff, it got more R&B ish.
Yeah,
with rap over top of it.
Yeah,
kind of thing.
Yeah.
Yeah, kind of. They say mumble rap, but it kind of R&B ish.
Yeah.
With the rap over top.
Like now it's just like, right now, a lot of it is just very R&B ish. With the heavy rap. 808 and then rap.
Right. Yeah, exactly. But I'm hearing a lot of stuff now with no melodies.
No.
Yeah, and just the 808 just got. 808 got the melody.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And like that Kid Brick song, dope. But it ain't got no sound, just a beat.
It's drums. Just drums.
But like I say again, it's what the artist put on it.
Yeah.
You know, that's half of the battle right there. What the artist put on it. You know.
So this is one of Michael Joe made joints I did. It's called Watch Out.
Yes, sir. I'm here for the booty. Rich epic booty. Uh-huh. Woo! That boy pretty right there. Yes, sir. I got nothing.
Watch out for the big girl.
Watch out
for the big girl.
Big girl.
Watch out for the big girl.
Big girl.
Watch out for the big girl.
Watch out
for the big girl.
Watch out for the big girl.
Watch out
for the big girl.
Watch out
for the big girl.
Watch out
for the big girl. Watch out for the big girl. Best believe I'm gon' hit
right there. Yes, sir.
Ain't nothing wrong with a thick girl. I love it all.
That's curvy.
That boy pretty
good. Yeah, watch out for the thick girl. 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 Drop it down low. Walk slow. 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 Big girl. Big girl. You love this face, sick girl. Work out, get it, girl. I love me a nice little fit, girl. Do you wanna come over? Said that you do yoga. Baby girl, just roll over. Rub on your booty real slow. Spread on big girls, got a real pound cake. A big girl, throw the cake in your face. I love all flavors, don't discriminate. Just out your back, your booty a taste. Watch out for that fit, girl. Watch out for that fit, girl. Watch out for that thick girl. Watch out for that thick girl. Drop it down low. Walk slow. 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 A thick girl just so curvy. Add a couple pounds, make it all worth it. I love big girls and I can't explain. That pound cake made me want to scream her name. She confident, showing all her features. Feel like heaven grabbing on a crease.
I'ma tell you, ain't nothing wrong with a thick girl. G-P-H-A-T. She PHAT. Girl, you juicy.
Work it out.
Girl, you juicy.
Work it out.
She PHAT. She PHAT. Girl, you juicy.
Work it out.
Okay, girl, ladies. You juicy. Okay, ladies. Let's go. Work it out. Fun. Work it out. Fun.
Watch you for the
come on, girl. Watch you for squeeze them glutes. Work it out. Fun. Work it out. Show the fun. Girl, I need those pound cakes, sweaty ladies.
For that girl,
she get on the floor.
For that girl,
walk in the mirror, she fat. Work it out,
watch she fight.
Walk in the mirror, girl, she fat. Work it out,
watch she fight.
Get on the floor,
girl. Watch for that girl,
she fat.
Watch for that girl,
she fat. Get on the floor,
girl.
Look in the mirror, girl.
Watch.
That's the best thing, though.
No,
we have cups.
My boy can't hit to get y'all turned.
Yeah, we've had.
I was about to break a bottle. I said it made too early.
I did. I ain't gonna lie. I brought some Quavo.
It's a cup right there, bro. I mean, if you want to.
I mean, this bitch twirled up.
No, oh, man. So next round, man. Let's go. You gonna rock paper scissors again? Y'all gonna go?
Because
he won. So
you gotta beat that nigga, man. Smell good. We got the crown in the building, baby.
I just want a real ball.
The crown has officially been in the building.
I did my little workout this morning. So I can.
You think I'm good?
That's how I'm gonna do it. One hit a quitter.
Shot down.
Ooh, baby. I feel like one of my uncles back in 72. Ooh.
That's it. That's him.
That's him right there. Let's go. Oh, shit.
Right? Take it. You got to go like this with it. You're like, hold up. Ooh. Ooh, shit.
Harlem shake around that bit.
Facts.
It hit the back of your throat, son. Woo.
Yeah.
I say, fuck it, man. I just go. I just cook. I ain't going to lie.
What's that?
That's me.
What's BPM?
85.
Bring it up. Oh, actually,
Speed up, let me see it. Go to 100.
Go ahead
at
120.
Shit, dude, that Fruity Loops.
That wasn't even me.
Oh,
caught you real quick, girl. A lot going on in life right now. I feel like our relationship is in an entanglement. You know what I'm saying, girl? You know, I know, girl, we're going through an entanglement right now. It's like me and my side chick and you and your side dude. And, you know, we gotta figure this out, you know?
Yeah.
the chord.
Oh,
that was probably the chord.
Yeah, it's probably the chord.
Yeah, it's the chord. Get new chords, man. Put the boob under it. You like push it up.
All right.
That's
I feel triggered.
So that was
Entanglement.
Entanglement track.
What's going on?
Entanglement.
Oh man.
That's it right there,
boy. So you another one. So mm-hmm. You get the choice to play another beat or song to promote, brother. This is the
Yes.
Yeah, man. Beats and songs. You know what I mean? Let people hear what you've been working on, you know, whatever.
Out there, man. There's people watching you on TV, man.
Let's see.
Hey, Ma. My mom, but I told you about all the cussing. Are you drinking too?
Let me listen here, Leachy. You say you like to dance. This Tampa. All oh, yeah, yeah. I made this song right here for you. Tampa.
Tampa tangles, baby.
I'm not internationally known, but I'm known to rock a microphone. Bitch, don't act stupid. Hold your group. If we gon' fuck, then we gotta make a movie. I'm just like a car with no top, I'm ruthless. I made the game, just like Tukey. Boy, I'm the shit, nigga, just like Duke. It crack cocaine, how you acting like Pookie? Fuck a nigga dick, make it feel like ruthless. Ride a nigga dick, MK in the movie. Who's optional? All of my ops wanna shoot me. Pull up to the set, nigga, we can shoot a movie. Shouts out to all y'all shaking y'all booty. COVID-19, whole squad got gooted. Ride round in the car with the pounds like Rudy. And I like it nasty, just like Boosie. Shake it to the ground, to the flow, taste cool. Just stamp a bay flawless, stop acting stupid. I don't like hoes that be acting all goofy. You know you gon' fuck, so stop acting bougie. You be too turnt, I know you take exes. You got an old man, so why you keep texting me? I'll hit you later, my bitch laying next to me. A little bit, you can call a whole man. Say hand in my lap, hand on the best of me, speaking in tongue. I call that bitch blessing me. I'm not internationally known, but I'm known to rock a microphone. 2015, I still had a beeper. Chevy Avalanche, 6 car, no lease. Age of 27, I bought illegal. First apartment, I brought all my people. Strippers every day like goodies and teasers. Brought y'all something that I kept on an eater. Dreaming that's all, let it come to a sleeper. I bust on a bitch like condom on Peter. Financially stable, just check my demeanor. At least a bitch, give her back to her people. I'm not internationally known, but I'm known to rock a microphone, bitch.
Doing this to make the beat.
We gotta make it pop. Need them little things.
Gotta do what you got to do.
So I got the y'all remember XXX, the Vin Diesel movie? He was like a little crime fighter super. The first one.
The first one, okay.
So that was Ice Cube. That scene in the room where he had the chick with the crazy ass fucking bed and shit.
Let me see what you
know. I'm saying I didn't flip that song.
Oh man. Oh. I've been doing that lately. I've been listening here in the movies, watching movies. I'm like, I'm watching Karate Kid. I heard something. I'm like, one and two. I'm like,
you gotta be like the real Karate Kid or like the city Karate Kid.
One and two.
Like the real one.
like simplify. That's
totally different.
I've been trying to simplify my beats because, like they say, you got too much going on. Or I hear
these days, yeah, they won't.
You know what I'm saying? This got to be real simple. You know
yeah, because it's weird. Like you said, like I started listening to instrumentals, and it's like if you listen to instrumental, the beat just never stops.
Yeah,
it just.
Yeah, it just
keeps going. There is no really change ups. Yeah, it's just small stuff taken out, but it's like the melody itself never really changes.
But me, nah. Every 4 to 8 bars, you getting that.
So I just started doing that. I'm just like,
I've been listening to a lot of soundtracks lately, particularly more of the anime soundtracks.
Oh, I love anime soundtracks.
I was just listening to Sword Art Online this morning.
What you got for us, Brick?
I did something. I wasn't that Donnie Brisco, what it's called? Brisco?
Johnny Depp. It's old school, right?
They got some nice sounds in there, man.
Yeah, man.
You got me on, sir?
Go ahead, brother.
You got me.
Niggas looking like I had it wrong. Niggas looking like I had it wrong. Niggas looking like I had it wrong. Now them niggas know I had it right. Niggas looking like I had it wrong. Now them niggas know I had it right. Niggas looking like I had it wrong. Now them niggas know I had it right. Niggas looking like I had it wrong. Now them niggas know I had it right.
Let's say Traxx. Give some up and comers some advice, bro. Like that you would say when you started. Like, what would you tell them?
It's different from when I started. Today is today. In the times now, I say the best thing is to stay humble. Learn how to be a people's person.
Mm-hmm.
You know. Get away from Tampa. I ain't saying stay away. Just, I ain't say stay away.
I understand what you're saying.
Just get away and meet other people and just stay up on your craft, you know. Like we were saying, it's the difference between a beat maker
and
a producer. You know.
I feel like Raw was about to get that Dave Chappelle speech. Where it's like, I need to get to dancing.
Yeah, all that.
He's like, get your ass out of Tampa.
Nah, but I understand what you said. Like, don't like keep you yourself.
And then a lot of young producers too. A lot of dope young producers because it's different now. It's easier. Like when I started on making beats, I was just on a MPC and a Triton keyboard, midied up, and you had to track everything through the MPC.
The fun days.
If I didn't have the MPC, I just track everything through the track and the motif.
Mm-hmm.
You know, it's way different and difficult. Yeah. But now they got VSTs. You can press VSTs. You can press one button and it play the song for you, play the beat for you. You know what you're trying to do, and that's all good. You know, everything's a talent. Everything, everybody don't hear the same. So all the everything is good. However you make your beat, however you make it.
Mm-hmm.
But, you know, it's good to learn a little theory. You know, yes. And that would take you over the top.
So what's your trade? It won't make you, you know, the best, but if you learn a little theory with the music, you'll understand. Yeah, you'll understand what's going on more. And I'm still learning theory. You know, I'm still learning a lot. I learn from everybody, man. That's the thing, too. You got to be able to learn from different people. Mm-hmm. And keep your eyes open and watch, you know. But if you're in Tampa, man, you got to get away and get them beats out, man. Don't be trying to hold the beats. Have your business right. Facts. Have all your business right, and shit, sometimes if you think you got a good producer, that's what I've been told. So I'm telling you what I've been told. Send that shit out. Give it to an artist that you think is dope. Don't ask him for no money. Just have your business together. Give him a beat, and you know, give that shit out, man. And
like, it's okay to lose beats a little bit. Get
your points on it. That's all. Get your points.
Like I was talking to a super producer named Bricks Main. He produced a lot of stuff from Young Thug, the Plies. I mean, he's a dope producer. And he was like, man, Raw, stop trying to send these beats off to Young Thugs and all these producers. I mean, all these artists. Find an artist in your city and produce. You're a producer. Produce. Once you make them hot tracks, they'll come looking for you. Nice. So that's what I'm trying to do now. I'm just trying to work with artists that I know that's dope. You know,
that's the formula. A lot of people don't realize that is that think of every major artist. They've all started with, even from like producers, they all started with artists they knew of in their own city. Yeah. And then they just happened to come up together. Just like Noah 40 and Drake and a Boy Wonder, and just like with Jetson and DaBaby, it's like he created him a different sound.
You plugged
and
in?
And they just expanded together. Yeah. That's how it works, is that you just attach yourself sometimes to an artist or producer, and you help each other grow. You know?
That's
and then
how
everybody
that
wants
sound.
To fuck with you.
Once you point. Make them hot, y'all make each other hot.
Yep. Just like with Young Chop. It's like he was doing stuff for everybody in Chicago, and then he got put on, and then everybody was like, oh, shit, I want some of your beats now.
You want your beats, yeah. And as I was looking at another podcast with Kodak Black, one of his producers, and the dude, he's from down south, and he was like, man, I couldn't get on sending beats to these big coming rappers. Mm-hmm. I couldn't get on that way. I got on just dropping hits in my city, and then when people came, who's the hot producer? His name was one of the ones that was mentioned. So that's how he got with Kodak Black. You know, people was mentioning his name in the city, and he started dropping songs. You know, he was already dropping hits in the city, but he was like, man, I couldn't get on by sending beats off. I got on by working with artists in my city.
Yeah.
So,
you know. You hear that, producers? So, work with these local artists. Stop getting them YouTube beats. You know what I'm saying?
Like, I get you. Everybody want to work with the Jay-Z's or whatever. And
the Futures.
You know, the Futures and the Little Babies.
Right? Yeah.
It can happen, but it's like, sometimes it steps to make that happen. It just doesn't happen overnight. Unfortunately, it just doesn't.
You got to think of how many producers in their inbox every day.
Yeah, exactly.
Like you think I know your mama say you the hottest thing in the street, but everybody mama say they the hottest thing in the street.
Yeah.
So it's like, it's just you against other motherfuckers.
Other mamas.
Exactly. You know what I'm saying?
Nah, man, but.
Your mama ain't wrong, but they mama ain't wrong either. So, you know.
Yeah, man, I just want to, you know what I mean? You got to try to, you know. Coach these youngins, you know, while you can. You know what I mean? Because, hey, it's a lot of them out here that need it. There's definitely a lot of them out here that need it, man.
Right. And quit spending all your money on weed, nigga. Invest in studio time. Shit.
Facts.
Like, damn, if you get a stimulus check, I'm sorry, I don't mean to rant right now. I'm being real with it. It's like, nigga, if you got $40, $60, you know what I'm saying, for a re-up, nigga, that's an hour you can spend on the studio time.
I'm getting your song right.
Like, why your shit gotta sound like shit because you ripped it off YouTube?
Shit, you give that $40 can put your song out on all the platforms.
You know? I mean, might as well put it in something that you already like doing.
Right. Don't look at me, man. I got you up the whole time, bro. I ain't touched it, bro. You were just playing something five seconds ago.
Wiz mad right now because he got a flea market MK3. It ain't working like he wants to. Wait, he needs old ass crackers. trying to figure shit out right now.
Facts.
He going through an entanglement right now with his NPC and these crackers. So,
look, that works.
it not planned? Yeah.
So we only got like 8 minutes on the show. Because the show is at 4 o'clock. We got 2 hours.
I used to look up the blueprint.
Oh yeah. You know what, today Alfie's the guest. He can pick the blueprint.
Oh shit. Alfie, what you gonna do, son?
Pick a blueprint.
You know what? Like, sorry about earlier. Karate Kid.
What?
Pick a beat from
Karate Kid. They got a theme song, do it?
No, you gotta, it's gotta be a song.
Oh, be
or
a song?
Something like an instrumental, kinda like the Fox theme intro, you know, the.
It could be any goddamn.
I mean, what if you, if y'all wanna do it, that's on you. I'd like to pick stuff that's instrumental so it's easier for y'all to chop.
Okay. Well, you want to get earlier.
Who?
Dop, 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 dop.
Anime.
I don't remember that one.
Google it, or better yet, go to YouTube, because they do have a soundtrack there. I was listening to earlier today.
See, this is why we don't let the brother of the other brother.
Yeah, he picks some obscure shit.
Picks some obscure shit that ain't nobody never heard of.
Let's see.
My shit's malfunctioning. Hold on.
Watching that shit on. We got them with Boosie and Valley TV. Oh. What's his name? He told us on.
Yep.
He said,
Night Rider. Boy, you did
Night Rider. Never did Night
Rider. No, I don't think we did Night Rider.
It feels like we did Night Rider.
Okay, look. Rush around. Let's go.
Nigga, we only got like 5 minutes. We still got to do the thing.
People have made beats in last time.
Yeah, just to see what you can come up with.
Fine. Yeah, you want five? You want a 2 minute beat? All right, here you go. Let's go. It's 95 BPM. I don't know why I'm quicker. My thing ain't plugged in, bro. Okay. Godzilla had muscles. Like forearms like a muscle in the head.
But at least he fixed it.
All Godzilla needed was some pinballs and a hoodie, and he's like, yo, I'll have your ass. Okay. I swear to God, they had Godzilla. You put Godzilla in with a hoodie and some pinballs, they're like Dwayne on 23rd. He's like, hey, go that way. Dwayne lay down there. So go down. Alright, here you go. 3 minutes. And now Sergio about to bless us with the motherfucking blueprint. Where's the blueprinty, baby?
Let me get Ladies that. Let me get gentlemen. That cord.
Hey, Traxx. I got it. Tell them where they can find you at.
Yeah, man. Social media.
You can get me, goddamn it, Raw Traxx, man, at Facebook. Mm-hmm. Tari Raw Traxx Smith. And on Instagram, you can get me at Raw Traxx. At Raw Traxx.
What about SoundCloud?
SoundCloud, Raw Traxx.
Raw motherfucking Traxx.
Three Raw Traxx. With two X.
What about back?
Two X. I'm going to add three X and add okay. some titties on there.
Hey.
That's going to be real Raw.
Real Raw Traxx. Raw.
Real Raw.
Hey, I know Missy Stone hooked up.
With the titties.
That's true.
I do.
With the new
like she looked
at. God damn. Hey, again, man, I appreciate y'all, man, hey, for bringing me out the house today, oh, man.
Thank you for coming, brother.
I've been in the house today, man, doing shit, looking around, trying to figure out life.
Hey, man, it be like that sometimes.
You got to, man. Like you go crazy. You're so crazy in the house. Yeah. And then if you got kids and, like, the wife and the family. Oh, man. You know, like,
then wife at work. My two daughters gone. They granddaddy. My son at the house. He probably playing pocket pool or something. Knowing him.
Wrong motherfucking Traxx.
For y'all listeners wondering what pocket pool is, you gonna have to figure that out for yourself. Okay, because I don't know who listening right now, because it'd be minors, and I don't want. Urban Dictionary tell you everything.
I appreciate you coming through, man, dropping some knowledge, you know what I mean? Sharing your stuff with us, you know? Really appreciate that.
Yep.
What you got, man?
All right, so this song went number one on the charts back in the, I want to say, late 80s, early 90s, not 100% sure.
Oh, shit.
It's real simple, very catchy. Everybody knows this, so enjoy.
Is that Bobby McFerrin?
Yep. So sample it, drop some beat on it, do whatever you want to.
Hey, like, so each time we do it, bro, you can send your shit in.
Yeah, so if you at home and if you got producers tuned in right now, and y'all want to flip this, send it in, flowhioradio@yahoo.com, or y'all got a, you got an assembly line email?
Yeah.
Here's a little song I
I'm just letting y'all know right now.
Is it really
I'm
this
killing shit. Okay, I'm gonna murder the fuck out of this beat. On my word. Okay? I'm gonna fucking murder this
on
beat.
On my word, son.
Okay? If this beat got children, I'm sorry, but hey, I'm about to murder this motherfucker.
Fucking this kid.
Okay? Y'all about to be orphans off this track.
Yeah!
Be happy.
Here you go.
That's that part right there.
Yeah. That's what I'm saying, bro. This whole
can
thing
you
got.
Just with a high that track beat, you like,
oh,
yo.
My God.
Think I'm playing, baby. Yeah.
That's the answer. You like, woo. Worry,
yeah, we're just trying to bring it back, bro. Revise this.
I'm going to speed it up.
Woo. I know some people that might drop
you
know,
a hard club. You know, I'm going to be a club.
This is going to be a club fast smacking track.
Think I'm playing.
Okay. Matter of fact, I'm telling you right now, this is Brixton Bang's fast smacking track of the week.
That's what we got. That's what we got. Next episode, Bobby McFerrin, Don't Worry, Be Happy. Producers, if you out there, if you want to participate, by all means, go right ahead. Flip it, send it to us, flowhioradio@yahoo.com or the assembly line.
Yes.
At what?
Gmail.com.
At gmail.com.
Yep. And I can tell you my title for the track right now. My title for the track going to be Don't Worry, Be Trappy.
Oh,
that's how it's going to be, baby.
You shouldn't have even
said
nothing.
That's how it's going to be, baby.
You shouldn't have said nothing.
Okay.
Oh,
don't worry, be trappy.
Oh my God.
Let's do this.
That's my motherfucking co-host.
Yep.
Okay. That's how we gonna do it right now, son.
On the fly.
Don't worry, be trappy.
Oh my God.
I like that.
Y'all already know what it is. Y'all got any more shout outs before we get out of here?
Hey, J Wiz, J-O-5 Wiz on IG. My producer page, Double M2 Pro.
Me at Brixton Bang everywhere. Twitter, Snapchat, Instagram.
GoFundMe.
Facebook.
Cash real. App. Cash App, Flo-hio.
You know what I'm saying?
Fans all caps. Only.
Facts.
For you real. Know,
Farmer's Paradise.
Ladies, if you got that $40, you know what holla
at me. His up.
Ashley Madison.
Yeah. Got you.
Yeah.
We are 40.
You already know what it is.
Instead of we are 18.
I'm dead.
We are here.
Opportunity. Raw Traxx.